South Emsall, near Pontefract. Dear Mrs. Boothby, I am very deeply touched by your letter of thanks, and I am sorry that what I did was of so little effect. The explosion occurred about 7 a.m. It was reported to me about 6:45 a.m. that the workers at the face had heard sounds of talking coming through the earth, and when I went to investigate, I was of the same opinion. I stopped the working in that part of the mine to avoid risk of our detection, and went immediately to our CO to put the matter before him, for it is the custom in tunnelling for the less experienced to report to the officer in charge, if time permits, to get the benefit of his experience and help. I found your boy just getting up, and when I told him what had occurred, he decided to go up with me at once and slipped into his long boots. On our way up to the mine, we discussed the situation, and he said there was no need to take definite action until we were quite sure, as he was very much against alarming the men until there could be no possibility of a mistake about it. And he pointed out that as the talking was so unguarded, there was every possibility that our men had not been heard by the Germans. It was just that self-reliance and careful weighing of facts and absence of flurry that made him so valuable to his junior officers and the men. He went at once to the suspected gallery, taking with him to the head of the gallery the man who had reported the sounds. As the gallery was very small and a third listener would have been in the way, I stood at the entrance of the gallery to ensure quiet in the main gallery during the listening. About half a minute later, the explosion occurred, and as soon as I could get clear of the wreckage, I sent a man back to get help and went in to see the extent of the damage. I found the gallery entirely blocked for almost the whole length with earth and broken timbers, and was almost immediately made insensible by the fumes. From the severity of explosion, and the fact that he was so near the seat of it, apart altogether from the absence of air, your boy's death must have been immediate, and I know he would be ready. I know I express the feelings of the officers and men of the company in saying how deeply we shall miss his quiet confidence and cheerful coolness, and we share with you the loss of a very brave and gallant gentleman. Believe me, Alex W. Wilson, 2nd Lieutenant, R.E. P.S. My wounds are healing very well indeed, and the doctor thinks that I shall be quite well again in 3 or 4 months, if I take care of myself. Yours sincerely, A.W.W.